So this past week I released a video, and the video was, I'm quitting prepping. And the reason that I did that video was because I'm sure there's a lot of people out there that have started prepping, or that could be already prepping, and you feel like you're overwhelmed, you're running out of space, you don't know what else to do, you don't know where to put all this stuff that you're prepping. You know, you're following what you're supposed to be doing and everything else, and you're catching all the good sales, you're buying up the products, you're getting the buy one, get ones, you're using your coupons, you're doing all this kind of stuff, and you have no place to put it. You've run out of room to do things and to store things, which is a legitimate reason for probably a lot of people to stop adding to their preps, is what you really don't want to do. You want to constantly keep adding. Even if you are on a maximum space, you've utilized anything and everything that you can do. And in today's video, I'm going to show you something that you can do that I've done to give me more space in my home to store more products. So thank you for joining me today on Survival Preparedness for Beginners. And we're going to be talking about doing some storage and ways you can store a lot of different things. Now let's go look at some stuff that we can do for long term. Change some room and I'll be right back. Don't go anywhere. All right, the other day on the video where I was talking about quitting prepping, I was talking about the reason I brought the topic up was basically because people run out of space, as I was just talking about. One way you can get around that, folks, one way that you can really start maximizing space and stuff. The room that this is in, this is a spare bedroom. Okay, I have a bed and a nightstand and preps. We don't really have company that often. And if we do, well, I'll give them a spoon and a fork. And if they get hungry, they got plenty to eat. But point being is, you can take a spare bedroom. You can buy yourself a couple of racks. Now, I really like this rack here. All right. Now, this rack here, they both were just about the same price. Pros and cons, okay? Pros to this one is it already has a flat surface built into it, all right? Which is really great for storing all the canned goods. This one here doesn't. It's a wire rack, but you can't get around it. Like on the bottom shelf, down at the very bottom, which I'll show you here in a second, I just took and put a piece of cardboard down there that I was stacking a lot of my canned goods and stuff on the bottom of the shelf. I ended up making this one more of a dry shelf and this one more of a canned goods shelf. Now, somebody did comment in my video that, well, I hope that's not all the preps you have. Well, I'm not really going to show you everything I have. You really don't want to be broadcasting everything that you do have. I'm showing you some of the things that I do have. Because there's quite a bit of food here. Even if this was all you had, okay, folks, you could last a very, very long time on what is on these shelves right here. You don't have to have a whole grocery store. You have to get smart in your preps. You have to get smart in how you cook. You have to get smart in what you're making and how much you can maximize and spread out that food to survive. And remember, it's not a smorgasbord. When the natural disaster, or when in the emergency situation, I should say, this way here covers just about anything and everything without mentioning anything. You all know how YouTube is. So this way here, under an emergency situation, you have some preps. Something that you can survive on for quite a long time. Two people on what you see in this shelving systems right here, I mean, you could last for quite a while. You've got plenty of pastas. You've got, there's right down there is what, 30 pounds of rice, just in bags. I haven't put it away yet, my Marlar bags, but just in bags, okay? You've got coffee. You've got ramen noodles, mac and cheese. You got breadcrumbs. You've got butter. I've got everything I need here. You got vegetables, soups, beans, meats, the whole nine yards. So you got some way to store it. So the key of this video is you can pick up some of these racks. Now, depending on what size you want to get, because they do make them from a two-tier, 3-tier, 4-tier, and a 5-tier. So it's all on what size you want and how much you want to spend. And it's the same with this shelf. This shelf comes in a 3-tier, a 4-tier, and a 5-tier. I didn't see it in a 2-tier, but a 3-tier, 4-tier, and a 5-tier. And they're going to roughly run you anywhere between, depends on where you buy them at. You got to do your homework, because you really want to make sure that you're doing your homework and compare between Amazon, Walmart, Target, all these different type of places and everything else, because sometimes one has a better sale than the other, and other times the other one has the better sale. So it's just something, when you get ready to go and purchase a rack, make sure that you are doing your homework and you're seeing who's got the best deal, because it changes constantly. So I can't sit here and tell you, you know, I think I paid like 60 some odd dollars for this rack, and this one was like $72 or $73. So, I mean, they're pretty close together in price, but I did do my homework and found the best price for the particular product. Now, let's move right over and let's take a look at something else real quick. I want to show you what you can do. Okay, folks, so now what you're looking at are these little totes. These little totes are great, all right? You can pick these up at Walmart for $5.98. Now, what you can do is you can store things in them. As we can see right here, you know, I use this tote here and I put in a lot of my Mountain House, all my freeze-dried type foods, my MREs, and some of this stuff. Now, I have more than just this right here, because I do have all my packs and stuff all have MREs, freeze-dried foods, and everything else in it. And I do store some in a backpack that I can just grab and go. And there's also some in my emergency 72-hour kit. Now, see, I mean, so the great thing is these totes, you can just take, seal these up. Now, and this tote here, as you can see, all right, this is full of all kinds of goodies. I've got some vacuum-packed rice in here. There's flour, there's brown sugar, there's sugar, salt, and another thing of rice. So you can store these things in here with no problems and no issues, all right? And now I'm going to show you another thing that you can do that I've talked about that you can easily do with these totes and get them underneath this bed and still have plenty of room. Let me adjust the camera again, folks. Here we go. Okay, folks, where are we at? We're on the floor. Oh, Lord, somebody's going to have to come and call an ambulance to get me off the floor here in a second. But the point being is, I got these new bed frames. These bed frames are just amazing, all right? They are exactly, I don't know if you're going to be able to see that, 13 inches. Both these totes are on top of each other underneath the bed, all right? So you could put two here, two over there, and I have a big one on the other side that fits underneath here. Maximize the space. You can pick these bed frames up through Amazon. All right, if you have the single mattress type deal, you know, all the new mattresses are, you know, you don't have anything anymore that's really like the mattress box springs. Everything's gone to where you just have them, the frame, and then, you know, your mattress. So if you have that, you get one of these frames, and you can get them, they can be a little bit higher too, not much. It's usually like a 13, 14 inch type deal, but you're maximizing space for your preps, folks. And it's under your bed. Nobody can see it. It's a great thing. So this has been Survival Preparedness for Beginners. Thank you for joining me on this video on how to store your preps, places to store your preps, places you can put things where people can't see them. And even if they can, well, you don't want them to see everything. You can always throw a sheet over the racks or something and tell them to eat your linens. What do they know? Unless they're nosy people and they want to go in and start peeking. But nobody can see your preps under your bed. Not many people are going to go in your place and look and see what's under your bed. Because I really don't want to look and see what's under my bed. But I know there's preps under my bed. So I replaced this frame with my frame in my other room. I got plenty of room to store preps. So until next time, folks, I'm Survival Preparedness for Beginners. Thank you all for tuning in, joining in, sharing this video, liking it, subscribe, and whatever else. Now somebody please call 911 because I'm going to need help getting up. I'll catch you all on the flip side.